What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a daytime interior rendering in Twinmotion. Let's get started. There are two ways to import a SketchUp model. You can use the import menu inside of Twinmotion, then select a model that you want to import. Twinmotion supports lots of different 3D formats, but since I'm using SketchUp, I can use the Twinmotion plugin as well. You can get the plugin by going to this link here. Before I export, I will make some changes to the export settings. First, I will set the collapse to none. This will be important later in the video. Next, I will uncheck exclude objects smaller than 0.1 meter. Because if you turn this on, then small geometry in your model will not export correctly to Twinmotion. Once you are ready, click the See in Twinmotion button to export the model to Twinmotion. I will choose the New Project option. It will take a while to import depending on the size of your model. The first thing I do after importing is setting up the camera view. To do that, click the Media button, then click on Image, and click here to create a new image. Now you can adjust the view. I usually start with the time of day, which will affect the sun and lighting of the scene. If you click on the More button, then you can change more settings, such as the camera settings. I want a really high quality image, so I will set the output size to 4K. For the field of view, I will change it so that the camera is not too wide. The vignetting option will make the corners of the image darker, but I don't want that, so I will set it to 0. Next, I can click here to go back to the previous menu and choose Localization. Here you will see a map where you can choose the location of your project. This will affect the lighting of the scene. I will choose somewhere in the US. And here you can choose the month and the north offset, which will change the north orientation in your model. I will set mine to 90 degrees. Next is weather, which I will cover in more details in another video, but for now, I will use it to add some clouds to the scene. Then let's move on to lighting. Adjusting the sun slider will change the contrast between the sunlight and the shadows. The next slider will affect the ambient brightness of the scene. You can adjust the white balance to make your render cooler or warmer. GI or global illumination affects the way light bounces around your model. Since this is a daytime rendering, I'm not going to use the moon power slider. Next, you can adjust the shadow distance. Increasing it will soften the shadows, while decreasing it will sharpen the shadows. If the shadows in your scene has weird artifacts like this, then try increasing the shadow bias a bit to fix it. Finally, ambient occlusion will darken the corners in your model to make your render look more realistic. Next, I will go to visual effects. In the color gradient category, I will change the contrast and saturation a bit to make the image look better. Now that I'm happy with the lighting of the scene, I will start editing some materials. To start, click on this eyedropper tool here, and select a material that you want to edit. Adjusting materials is very straightforward. You can adjust the reflection to make it more reflective like so. For metal materials like this one, you can increase the slider to 100% to make it more metallic. And if the material looks too dark, then you can change the color here. There we go, now just repeat this process for all the materials in the scene. Twinmotion also has a built-in material library. Just drag and drop a material from the library to your model to apply it like so. Remember that you can change the color of the materials within the Twinmotion library too. The scale slider is also useful for adjusting the size of your material. Here I have a small rug, but I want to remove it and use Twinmotion's asset instead. You can see that deleting it from the asset list on the right side does not work. This is because I used the SketchUp plugin to import the model. So back in SketchUp, I can remove or hide the object, then click this button again, and it will update it in Twinmotion. Pretty cool, huh? Now I can look for a rug in Twinmotion and add it to my scene. You can use the different tools here to transform your object as needed. The carpet material in Twinmotion actually looks really good. If your custom materials have maps such as reflection and normal maps, then you can import them into Twinmotion like so. I'll show you how to do this in more details in another video. Sometimes you want to change a material of a specific object instead of replacing all the materials like this. To do that, click and hold this icon and change it to Apply Material to Object. Then you can apply the material to a specific object like so. Note that this is only possible if you use the None or Keep Hierarchy options for the collapse setting when you import. There we go. When you're happy with the scene, you can go to Export, select the image, and click Export, then select a folder where you want to save your render. And that's how you can render an interior scene in Twinmotion. If you want to get Twinmotion, then go to this link here. Make sure to get it while it is still free. And that's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below and let me know what you think of the software. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.